Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Gamer Guide channel. I am Rollin, and we're looking at a new game I picked up on Steam called Airships, Conquer the Skies. It is in the build and compete genre, sort of like Robocraft and like Crossed Out, but this is a 2D platform versus a 3D platform, sort of like, you know, Terraria would be to Minecraft, in other words. Simple graphics made by a single guy named David Stark. A great game so far. This is one of those that got me hooked overnight, and I played like an entire conquest and totally screwed up my sleep schedule like a week ago once trying this out. So I think you guys might enjoy checking this out. Like I said, out of the games similar to Robocraft, this actually was the highest reviewed game on Steam. So everybody seems to really like this game. If you can get around the simplistic graphics, it's really a lot of fun. So figured we'll try it together. There is multiplayer, as you see. September 11th is the next multiplayer hour. So you can get with other people who play this and compete online. But we're going to go ahead and just get into Conquest, and I'll show you a little bit of the basics of the game. So in Conquest mode, you're going up against other AI players and also little monsters and stuff. First thing you want to do is you'll make your sigil. I kind of made this one last time, which is a little green and white, but you can customize this to be whatever you like it to. And there's different bonuses based on what you choose. So like steel armor, absorbing 50% more damage is what I chose with the a little anvil. So we're going to name this Rawlings. That's going to be our city name in it. And if we wanted to go ahead and jump in and maybe modify this, I can show you real quick how that works, I suppose. We can do that by clicking Edit Arms. So in this screen, we can change our different emblems, our colors. Of course, it's all really simplistic graphics, but we'll go with the blue and white anvil maybe in one corner. And maybe we can put another blue and white on the other opposite corner for this one. So all different kinds of things you can choose. Like we can do a gear there if we want to. And let's see, we need to figure out how to put blue in the bottom right corner. Okay, that's how we change the color of the mountain. But let's see, if we do this, there we go. So now we have a blue and a green and white flag. We'll go with that for this particular episode. All right, so each time you create a new conquest, it creates a randomly generated map. So every game's a little different. But here's Rawlings. We're kind of on a little island, and we have our neighbors around us. As you see, all the different little emblems and town names for our NPC enemies. You also run into like what I would consider monsters or things that are not particularly with a faction, like the thing that says Mad Scientist on the screen. Those are things you can just defeat as a challenge to get extra cash. So what I probably want to do is start by building an airship for you guys, so it makes a little more sense. And we'll click through some of these little helpful messages when you start a new game. But yeah, let's go ahead and we'll jump into our town and we'll build something so this game makes a little bit more sense to y'all watching this for the first time. So by clicking on defenses here on our main menu, we can go in and see what we actually have for our starting airship, which is here. We've got four cannons on it. I haven't actually seen this one before. It was, I think, one created by another player and uploaded to sort of the market or whatever you want to call that. Suspendium here keeps us aloft, and some of the other modules I see here you'll recognize as we put together our first ship. But we got a propeller. Looks like we have some kind of other suspendium mechanism. I don't think I've ever used this particular one in my ship, so I'm not quite sure what that is. Four cannon. It's called the Barty Chain, so that shouldn't be too bad. We got that to start with, at least. We have some marine quarters on there, too, to defend our ship, which is always nice. So we're probably going to end up building something from scratch. Let's take a look at our starting home tower. Here's our base. You can also build buildings in this, and you can build tanks and walkers, all kinds of cool stuff. You can also refit existing buildings. So if we wanted to come in here and see like what we had for armor, you can click on that and see. It looks like we have, not steel, probably stonewall armor. Yeah. It's really heavy, but it's great for buildings and super tough. So yeah, and looks like we also have a prop plane on the top. This is a pretty cool little building to start with. So not bad at all. Pretty nice starting defense structure. But let's go ahead and we'll jump into building something real quick. All right, we're going to start by building an airship. And the first thing we'll need is something called Suspendium, which keeps you up in the air, basically. And it kind of makes the game easy in the way of trying to balance ships and stuff. As long as you have Suspendium on board, basically your ship's going to fly if you're not over your weight limit. To get that powered, though, for the regular powered Suspendium containers, you're going to need some coal. So we'll throw that in. That's a coal module. And then in addition to that, we probably want to have something for propulsion, like a propeller. So we'll see if we can find that real quick. Other things we're going to need to add to, that fire port would be real good to prevent the ship from starting on fire if we get shot, which will happen, obviously, since this is a combat game. Got a couple different choices here. We got propellers, we got engine pods. I've never tried this engine pod before. This is kind of interesting, but looks like it can be mounted on the top and leaves a lot of room in the front and back. Large propellers. That needs room on top and in back, so we might start with that, but I wanted to throw on that fire port here somewhere too. Okay, a little too big, so we're going to delete that real quick. Let's put the fire port on. I want it near the coal, so if our ship starts on fire, we don't lose our major fuel supply right away. So we're going to keep them close together. Keeps things a little more efficient on board. Now let's go back to our propeller. Let's see, where is that? Here we go. Okay, we got props, large propeller, regular propeller. And what else do we have? Cargo doors, all kinds of different stuff here. We'll go with the large propeller to start with. As I want to add a couple of the suspendiums on, and I want to be a little bit more efficient. I guess on top here, let's add another layer of stuff. Maybe another suspendium chamber, another thing of coal. Okay, I've jumped ahead in time. I added those things to it. And now we're going to add on a repair bay, and we're going to add on some crew quarters. Repair bay is just if we take damage on the ship, we can repair mid-fight. And the crew quarters, if I can find that here real quick. That's going to be what actually houses our sailors in it. We need this to basically populate our airship. So here it is, quarters, and you'll see what the recommended number and what you actually have on board up in little stats in the upper left corner. I'm going to move that back a little bit since it's kind of in the way. We'll put the crew quarters here in front. And you see, and now we have air sailors that kind of appear in our ship. So we're kind of fully populated now in each of our rooms. So you want to definitely make sure you have enough sailors on board or your ship just won't work really well. And you can also see here we got our costs, we got all the different stats up here in the upper left corner, so we got to make sure all these things work out right. Alright, now I'm going to add on some ammo rooms to this. We need this to power up our weapons, and if we only have one ammo room, I find that we run out a little too quick in battle, so I like to use two ammo rooms. And we'll add on some weapons and cannons and stuff here, probably more near the end of this build. But first, I think what I'd like to do with the ship is kind of make it a marine transport. I want to be able to take over enemy vehicles, take over enemy buildings by dropping marines into them and having them just storm the building and take everybody down. So that's the marine barracks there. Let's go ahead and add some of those to our ship. So each of these modules adds 8 marines, which can invade enemy forces, basically. So I'm going to add a couple of these on, as I want this to be primarily like an invasion ship. The smaller guard barracks, I think these only have 4, and the bigger ones have 8, and plus the marine barracks are also an invasionary force, so I think the guard barracks are only defense force. So we're going to use all the bigger ones, the marine barracks, here on the bottom. And let's see. Yeah, I don't really see any reason to add these other ones. I'm just kind of looking at cost and stuff, too. Weight's 45, so they're a little heavier, but yeah, 4 should work. The next thing we need to add on is this supply hatch. This is going to allow us to basically load our things into the airship. If you don't have that, it doesn't work. So you need to, up in the upper left corner here, make sure your supply is greater than your demand. So 40 over 28 should be just fine for that. All right, one of the other things we're going to need is a bridge. If you don't have that, you can't control your ship. And if you lose your bridge, you lose control of your ship, though it will keep fighting, basically without you able to command it. So these are pretty important. You don't want to put it somewhere where it's super vulnerable. And it'd probably be good to have it somewhere in the center of the ship. It doesn't need to be anywhere in particular. But I'm kind of low on space, and I'm probably going to armor this thing up pretty heavily. So we're going to just throw it here in the front for now. Next module I'm going to add is a sick bay. This is just going to keep our crew in good shape. If they get shot or something like that, they can get back into action a little bit quicker in battle. So we'll just stick that underneath the bridge. I think we're getting ready now to start thinking about adding more weaponry to this vehicle, as we kind of have a lot of the basics for this transport and stuff. Cannons are the most basic weapon, but there's actually quite a lot of stuff to choose from in this game for weaponry, though all that's pretty much underneath here in the advanced weapon menu. But we're going to go ahead and add a couple of cannons here to the front, as I like having those, and they do good damage and stuff like that too. So down here in our advanced weapon menu in the bottom, we see we have lots of different other options for weaponry. You can also reverse some of your camera positions and stuff, but you know, we even have saws, we got rams, we've got all kinds of stuff for melee combats, bomb bays, we could drop bombs on people's heads. I haven't really tried that one, so that may be kind of fun to add on to the vehicle. You know, grape shot guns, basically small cannonballs, all kinds of stuff. Let's go ahead and put on the bomb bays, as I haven't really had a chance to try those. We'll stick them down here a little bit lower. So let's stick one right there. And how are we doing here on requested or required sailors versus what we have? I don't seem to be up too much crew slots. So we'll put two bomb bays on it so we can drop some bombs on buildings and then drop our marines into them. That's kind of the idea here. We'll put another crew quarters here. Make sure we got plenty of people on board. So that should help our numbers. How are we doing? Air sailors 36 and recommended crew 32. So we're right up there. But as long as we have more than a recommended number, we should be in good shape. Let's go ahead and put a rifler up in front. This is good for taking out like small enemy aircraft, like bi-wing planes or something like that, and taking out troops on the ground. We need to fill something here in this little area. So maybe a deck gun or something would be good. I noticed we're a little over what we have in spending cash, but that's fine. We're just designing an aircraft, and we'll save up a little bit more money and build this thing after we get it all finished out, all fleshed out. I guess before we add more guns, let's go and look at our armor here. Right now we're using a wooden armor, but this is a little more susceptible to catching fire and stuff, so I usually like to go into steel armor. You see, you just basically coat your entire ship with this, and it protects it. Right now, I'm thinking maybe light steel or regular steel armor would be best. The steel is heavy, so it drops your maximum ceiling. So service ceiling, you know, you'll see that drop when I start coating this thing in steel plate. See the number going down there. It's like now 80, 76, 68. So we're raising our weight limit, and we don't want to exceed what our lift is over our weight, too. So we're going to have to keep an eye on that, or we might have to add some more suspendium to our airship to keep it flying. All right, so that's a problem so far. We're a super low level because our ability to lift our ship is now under what our weight ceiling is. But I do want to go steel, so we're definitely just going to make a couple modifications to keep this thing airborne. But it will be kind of a low-flying ship is what I want to do, have it close to the ground, but able to drop marines into enemy buildings and vehicles on the ground and stuff too. So let's continue with this in mind. Any module we add now should have steel armor on it, by the way. So we're going to go back to adding some weapons. And since we're going to be so low to the ground, I think the next thing I want to do is something for air defense. So we'll probably have airships and other things above us at some point. Let's go with a flat cannon. These are good at taking out enemy aircraft and things above us. They don't cost a whole lot too, so we'll stick them on top of our ship. Probably want to do, I think, maybe two of them. Not quite ready to add that yet, though. I think we need to maybe still work on our design a little bit here first. Next, I'm going to add a deck gun to the front. It's kind of a big cannon that we can use here, and is not very protective, but does a lot of good damage. And now to fix that problem we had earlier with our mass versus weight, I'm going to add a small suspendium chamber to keep our thing aloft and keep our lift over our maximum weight. Need to add our cargo door back in. There we go. So now we got that little small suspendium chamber I added there by the cargo door. We should be pretty good on our stats now. Service ceiling is 50 meters, so like 150 feet, but that's fine because we're going to be dropping people basically down into the rooftops of buildings and stuff like that. At least that is the plan. Yeah, got plenty of marine barracks here, so I'm feeling pretty good about the design so far. All right, we're going to add one more flat cannon to it just for good measure here on top, and I think that's going to pretty much complete what I want to do for this design. I don't want to make it too super expensive. And let's go ahead and rename this thing here too. Right now it's called the Centipede by default, but we'll think of something a little bit better. Okay, let's go ahead and call this thing Marine. Let's see if I can type here. Marine Hive. And what else? Mark 1, I guess. This is our first version of our less expensive troop drop, basically. We'll call it Mark 1. And that's pretty much going to complete it. So we're just going to go ahead and save this design, and then we can go ahead and build it later. So we'll go ahead and do that. We have plenty of slots here, so we got that saved, and now let's jump back out of here, and we'll start building it in our town. So the next thing I need to do is start time up here in the upper right corner. So I got that going, and now you'll see all the other factions will start to move and compete against each other too, not just against me. So it's kind of a everybody against everybody else sort of situation. And they usually do kind of fight against other AI. It doesn't seem to be like preferential towards combating human players or anything like that, like I noticed in some of the other games. But you'll see, like, this guy's moving his airship, and then we also have a faction like the Mad Scientist, which isn't really part of any of these different groups. It's just kind of like a monster, basically. You can go and take them out and get some extra cash and stuff if you want to take the challenge of, like, defeating the Mad Scientist. But there's also pirates and brigands and all different kinds of stuff you can take out of this game, so pretty fun. But we need to go ahead and build our ship here next, I suppose. So under the menu, we're going to click on build ships, and then let's see if we can find the one we just made. There it is. The Marine Hive Mark 1. We have also saved up enough cash to do that, so we'll go ahead and do it. And I could change the name here if I wanted to make it differentiated between other like ships. So if I build a whole collection of these Marine Hives, I might rename it like Marine Hive Mark 2 or whatever I want to do. And here you can see the actual build progress on your bar underneath your city name. So we can kind of keep an eye of it and see when we're done. And you can actually see it here in the town too when you click on it. I guess they're magic and they can fly around and construct in the air. But hey, we're not going for realism, right? This game's about fun. So anyway, 13%. We'll jump back out here. So we've got to restart time to actually have our ship construct. And we'll jump ahead here after we get the ship constructed. We also got some pirates here we need to take out, so we might hit them up first. All right, it looks like our airship just got done constructing. And so now we can click on our ships here, and as you can see, we can select which ones we want to move together, or we can separate them here in the screen. But we actually have some brigands in our own little territory, so I think I'm going to take them out first since they're going to probably be a more immediate problem. So let's go ahead and attack them real quick, and we'll start the time again. Now, here's kind of our setup screen for a battle. So they have one small building, and they have one mini tank. And we have two big airships, so this is going to probably be a pretty easy match. But I think what I'd like to do is use my Marine Hive to take over that tank, as we can capture vehicles and then use them in our own army. So it's not a real impressive tank, but let's go ahead and start our moving, or start our forces out wherever we really want to before we actually begin the battle. So that's kind of the nice thing of this. Now, this is such a low-flying ship, but I want to have it basically within range of that tank. And I'm going to bring this other vehicle down a little bit. I don't want it right up in the middle of the air for the building to hit more easily. So we'll both kind of focus the tank first, and then we'll run over to the little shack or whatever here and take these guys out in pretty short order. So let's go ahead and start the match. And see, we're already firing at them. Now I can pause time here and then give commands to the ship. Well, I want to board this little tank for sure. And I don't really want to destroy that tank, so I'm going to probably move this vehicle back up over the top here, and we'll have it start headed towards the town. All right, we got our Marines getting ready to jump off the ship, but we do need to move them closer to the actual tank itself. So let's go ahead and issue a command to get down near the tank. So we'll move it down where it's basically touching it, and then we'll let our Marines jump off into it. So you can see they instantly boarded the tank, and we took it over right away since they didn't have any defenses for an onboard invasion. So that is now ours. We'll have that tank after this mission is completed. We can add it to our collection. Let's go and take out the enemy town. It looks like our cannons have already taken out their deck guns, so they're pretty much defenseless now. So we'll go ahead and move our Marine Hive up close near to the building. And that probably was a mistake. I'm going to be like running into trees now. As this thing is not really smart about flight path, but fortunately we have pretty strong armor, so we can run through a couple trees and not destroy our ship. We'll move them both in close. We just need to eliminate that building, and when the little red X appears above it, it means we've done enough damage to basically take it out. And it should be out any moment here, as they don't seem to have any guns. So yeah, they've already been destroyed. So let's see, did we miss something? Because we've captured one. Oh, I guess we're just doing our little victory celebration. I see them all celebrating. So yep, captured the Brigand Raider 1 tank, and we took out the threat destroying the headquarters for the Brigand. So victory for our first conflict, and then both of our ships survived. So that's kind of the little splash screen you get after each battle. And we got 200 extra cash for taking them out real quick, so it's a pretty easy challenge. But let's go ahead and we'll move our airships and our tank now back to our town. As you see, if you group everything together, you can only move like one slot. So I usually like to take the land ships, this little Brigand Raider, out of my airships thing so you can move further. But for now, let's just move the tank back one slot. We'll keep it at home and we'll move our airships separately. So we selected that. Tank's back defending Rawlings, and then our airships are up there in the other part of our northern territory. And we'll go ahead and take out the pirates next, as that should be probably a pretty easy feat, and they'll give you better cash too. So in this one, looks like we have two of almost like a blimp-like ships for the pirates. I'm going to move back my main battleship, basically with the cannons, so we can hit those a little bit easier. And then this is going to be what I want to take over their base. And they have a little bit more formidable deck guns on there, so I'm going to keep that pretty much where it is. But we'll have one ship take out the two pirates, and the other one, I guess I'm going to go and immediately drop Marines into their headquarters. And with 24 Marines, I think we'll be able to do it pretty easily. All right, so let's start. Firing at them already. Okay, so we'll have that go over there. And let's see, I want to see if we can move down our other ship to get right in front of it so we can knock them out with some cannons. Alright, so we need to board now the base. So I have the orders out, and looks like they're already dropping in. And that solid green means that they don't really have any way to defend against my Marines. So we've already pretty much sealed our victory there. Just a matter of time. And now let's see how we're doing against the pirates. They've actually tried to board our ship, but we actually do have two defensive barracks on board, so we're probably going to be able to repel their invasion attack. Let's move our Marine Hive back over since we've already captured their building. And with our cannons now, we'll go and take out their airships. I would say I might try to capture these with my own Marine force on that little vessel, but these are pretty crap ships, and I don't really want to spend the tax on them to keep them in my fleet. So basically every ship in this game that you have money come out against your income and every building you build. So it's kind of realistic in that way, as there's like upkeep costs. So you don't want to have crap ships in your fleet. Let's move this down real quick, and it looks like we've already got victory. Everybody's celebrating. So just a matter of time now till we get the splash screen of victory. Nice. All right, we got the captured pirate headquarters, though. We don't get to keep that like another capital city, so you're not going to get this territory. But we did get 1,000 extra cash, which we can use now towards building more airships and cool stuff. And I guess we'll go and fight one of these NPC neighbors of ours, and I'm thinking we're going to do Coloran here next and see what they have. So one thing we can do is we can send spies over to their town. We have all different kinds of guys all around here, though. But yeah, I think probably Coloran will be their next target. So one thing we can do to see what they got going on is send a spy over to their town. Now, it costs us a little money each turn, so you don't want to send spies to absolutely everybody if you're trying to build up an army. But now, with the spy, we can take a look at their town. So I still have an income of 66 and 47.94 cash, so we're doing fine right now. See, looks like the spy is active now, so we can spy on their city by doing view city and kind of see what they have for forces. They have a real small little airship, and they have two pretty formidable looking buildings over there. But again, that's why we decided to do the invasionary Marine Hive style ship, where we can just run our Marines into their buildings and take them over instead of having to fight them the whole time. So if we could take out that little battleship or whatever, airship, and then to send our Marines in, I think we'll have a pretty quick and easy victory against these guys with their boar emblem. So let's go ahead and leave here, and I guess we're going to need to go ahead and create maybe another airship or so. All right, so we'll jump out here to the main menu. Let's go back into build ship, and let's see. Cloudwalker carrier. Some of these parts I think we can unlock till later, but we could see it's 5655 cash, and that is kind of the super carrier. It has four bi-wing planes, put in a bunch of Marines and a bunch of grenadiers, which are like elite Marines, and some of the biggest cannons on that thing. So it's a super cool ship I made earlier. Marine Hive Mark 1. I could probably go ahead and do one of those since I don't think we have the parts unlocked for anything besides that. Now, here's where I could change the name a little bit to kind of make them distinct from each other. So I could just put like Marine Hive Mark 1, 2, but that seems like a lot of unneeded numbers. So maybe we'll just make it Marine Hive 2, keep it more simple. All right, so let's go ahead and we'll let that thing build real fast. And we still have 66 income and 3,000, and we'll see a lot of people moving around on the map here. Yeah, it's fighting each other. So Kranzberg, it looks like up in the upper corner there, is taking over a little bit of territory. We got one extra capital. Now we got a foreign spy trying to sabotage our construction, so that slows us down a little bit and we lose some cash when that happens. Once we get the high alert. And there's ways to combat that. You can go up to Empire details and spend a little more cash to have like your anti-spy guys try to stop them from sabotaging your builds. All right, let's see. Do we want to do anything else here? other ships. Well, let's see. This Belial is a great little battleship. That's one that was already kind of pre-made. But lots of cannons on board, and it has a pretty heavy structure too, as it uses a different kind of armor on the bottom. I think it's called the keel, which protects it against shots. So we're going to go ahead and build one of those too, and that should be a pretty formidable air fleet to start out here. Again, we got another spy trying to stop us from constructing, so... Alright, so looks like the Borg guys just took over some extra territory, Coloran or whatever, who was going to be our first target. But that means they don't have anybody here to defend their home city. So we could probably easily take that over, especially as we have two of the Marine Hives, which could just run in and take those buildings out pretty much immediately, unless they have lots of Marines defending their base. So I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to move all our forces back together here, and then we'll move all our airships at once down to Coloran and take them out. We'll leave the tank at home for defense in case they're... forces up at Tape Jar in the north try to come down and attack us after we go to Coloran. But I think with our building there and one tank, that should be enough. So let's go ahead and run them down and see. We'll get 67 income per turn if we take out their city. So we got four of our ships here, including the new Belial, two of our Marine Hives, and our kind of starting battleship. All right, let's just get started. There's not really anything to worry about in this, as it's just it's taking out a couple of buildings. So we just got to maneuver the rocks here. And I find usually moving one of these transport at a time is the thing to do. And this is going to be kind of challenging because we have these like floating rocks there defending their base. So it's going to make it hard for me to get my big transports close to them. Oh, looks like we're going to run into each other too. Navigation is one thing you got to really work on in this game. So let's see if we can slip this guy under the bottom. And let's see, we can move the Belial out a little bit. I don't want to destroy their buildings, so I'd like to take them over if I can, so we're just going to do some moderate gamut damage. We probably could have just brought the two transports and nothing else, as this is going to be a especially hard fight, and we have decent armor on these things. Alright, so we're going to move our first Marine Hive Mark 1 all the way up to their building. See how close we can get here. We'll hide behind the rock, I suppose. These are not especially fast. Let's go ahead and move our other cannon ship up a little further, too, as it has a little higher ceiling. Alright, we're taking shots to the front, but we're doing okay. And let's see, I think I'm going to need to drop them close to the ground, as I'm not going to be able to get right above them as easily. So maybe we'll just drop our Marines out in front of the building and have them storm it. So we'll go and do the first one, drop them down. When they say like full reverse and stuff, that just means that they detected a collision. So it usually cancels your command as soon as that happens. So can we get a little bit closer here without... No, okay, they keep hitting the ground, so we're just going to have to select offload here. Got another ship coming in. Let's go and drop our Marines on the ground, and we're going to have them target that first base. So see, they're all highlighted there, and now they're dropping out. Let's zoom in a little bit, because they look like little tiny ants here on the screen, but you can... square your wheel to get a little closer. So we got, 32 Marines that are going to storm the building. And as soon as the first one reaches it, if they don't get shot, you'll see the meter here. And as they fight the guys inside, our green bar should grow and take over that base. So we'll bring our other dropship in, and let's move this one up to get it out of the way so we can bring our second set of Marines in for the secondary building. And looks like the progress has gone pretty good. They've already taken more than 50% of it. Let's bring the other ship in. There we go. We took it down pretty easily. Alright, we still got one more, but they surrendered in the other building. I guess they saw me getting ready to drop Marines, and they said, yeah, we've had enough. So, that was a quick, easy takeover of Coloran. And now there's different options for actually taking the city. So if you do general takeover, it doesn't really damage the city's buildings that much. It's better to do this if you wanted to retain that, especially for defense purposes. Brutal takeover does a little more damage to the buildings, but it takes over quick. So, you know, if you need to defend it and add some ships or something sooner, you would do that. Pillaging, you get a little more money, but it's kind of similar to brutal takeover. I think it's more destructive. So I'm going to go gentle takeover, as I think that's going to do the best long term. And we don't really have anybody that I'm worried about jumping into our base immediately. But, yeah, we did pretty well there. Now let's go ahead and take some of our fleet, and we're going to defend our northern city. Because I'm a little worried about them sending down troops from Tape Jar, the little boar head people. So we'll send half our fleet up there with the tank to defend Rawlings. And then we're taking over the city here. Let's see, do we want to build something else? We've still got 2,000 cash. We could go ahead and add maybe a new building to Rawlings, another defense building. So this has got lots of cannons on it, lots of rifles, so pretty tough. It's just called the Silent Watcher by default, so we're going to go and keep that. And let's put this building right next to our capital building. In case we do get invaded from something, this will help defend our territory from those enemies. So now we got a couple airships, a tank, and two buildings. Not bad. All right, so we are just finishing taking over Coloran, and now we have that extra 67 income that we can add to our income in Rawlings of 150. Wow, so that's actually really pretty high for our home city. So we definitely want to defend that, as probably other cities around don't have anything near to it. But guys, I think I'm probably going to end up wrapping this up here. It's been a pretty long episode, but I hope you guys enjoyed seeing some of the basics here about airship. We have lots of people to attack next time. Looks like we got some mad scientists out here and all kinds of things to take over. Before we leave off, though, let's just spy real quick here on Tape Jar and see what we're going to be up against in the next episode. So we'll go ahead and infiltrate their city. And let's say they're only worth 43 income, so it's not really a high-value target. Looks like they got one ship, which you could actually, if you had enough money, just maybe bribe them out of fighting us. So we'll go ahead and, I guess, do that in the next episode, as that doesn't seem like there's very much over there to resist us. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Please thumbs up the video if you did. I know it's been kind of a long episode, but I hope you got something out of it and you might like to see some more airship in the future. Anyway, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys in the very next episode. Later.